SRVM degree college. So today I am going to introduce the memories. PHP MySQL WordPress. Okay. This is the computer cluster paper SEMA. And this is paper is belongs to Third BSc Computer Science, 6th semester. This is for the Third BSc Computer Science, 6th semester, cluster SEMA paper, named as in PHP MySQL WordPress. Okay. So in previous class, I have discussed about the what is PHP and what are the basics of the PHP, what are the building blocks of the PHP, what are the basics of the PHP. Okay, so today I am going to teach the paper. I am going to teach the topic is PHP variable. What is PHP variable? So let us see here. So variable is a very important role while you're playing, while you're writing a program in any programming language. Okay, so without a variable, you should not write any meaningful programs in some programming languages. Okay, so like the variable can play a major role activity. Variable can play a major role activity while you're discussing at the time of the variable. Okay, variable can hold multiple values. A variable can hold multiple values based on the multiple data types. Okay, the variable should not take its own values. It can be taken by the help of the its data types. Okay, the data types can be depend the type of the variable, but not the variable not depend the variable data types. Okay, so if taking the variable as a data type, can take similar data types or relevant values can be taken here, or relevant data can be taken by the data types. Without data type, there is a no variable here. Okay, so variable can be used to declare here. So what is variable here? Okay, so variable is one of the container. What is that? Variable is one of the container to store the value. Store value based on the given data types. Based on the given data types, if you are giving data types, the basic data types or whatever data types, so the value can be stored here. Without the data type, there is a no variable also available here. It is utilized just like an alphabet of the English letter. Okay, so that's why if you want to store any variable, you have to use the data type, declare the data type. So that's why I'm using the variable names. Okay, so variable names are basically declared the variable. Okay, so coming to in PHP, if you want to declare any variable, you have to follow some sign. The sign is known as dollar symbol. Okay, the sign is known followed by the dollar symbol. It is only happening only in PHP style. Okay, so that's why the PHP variable is comes with dollar symbol sign. If you want to declare any variable in the program, you have to use that variable before to dollar symbol here. Okay, so let us see here. I will tell you how to declare the variable in PHP. Okay, so if you want to go into the PHP. Okay, so in PHP error, you have to enter. So this is called one of the example. So I will give you a definition what is variable here. So variable is identified. Variable is identified. So to see, feeling, look and feel. Look and feel is called as variable. The variable having its name, its own name. The variable should not be a keyword. Okay. Next, the variable should be starts with the alphabet that is called 0 to 9. And the variable first letter should not be a keyword. Variable name should not be a keyword. A variable first letter is always alphabet, and it does not accept any special symbols as in variable. It accepts only one symbol, that underscore symbol. Okay, so what is variable here? Let me explain. Variable is identifier whose value is changed during execution of the program. Okay, return or tell you the parameters. Variable is identifier whose value is changed during the execution of the program is called as variable. Okay, so based on the variable name, based on the variable value, the program result is always varies from one to another persons. Okay, because of the every person having giving his convenience values to the program, and the result is also getting from the based on the given input values. Okay, if you are giving input values of wrong, automatically the program take wrong values. Okay, so if you are giving valid inputs, it is also giving valid output. Okay, the output is based on the given. The output is always based on the input values. Okay, if you are giving input values of wrong, the output is also giving wrong. But not the, the program is not going to perform any extra work without help of the human beings, because of the computer is a no IQ power. It is a dumb terminal. Okay, that's why it's not thinking its own capacity. So it is always depends upon the user. Hence, the user can giving variable values that can be taken the values. It can be substitute the values and giving output of the program. If you are giving good values or valid input values, giving also valid output here. Okay, if you are not giving valid output inputs, it is also not giving valid output. Okay, sometimes it is called an error or quality here. So you are giving the not values, you are giving improper values, you are getting the output values also improper. Okay, the situation is known as here. Runtime errors. Situation is known as runtime errors. Okay, runtime errors can be managed by the exception handling topics in Java programming languages. Okay, or in C++ programming languages, whatever it may be. So runtime errors can be defined within system based languages. So that's why the user cannot understand this. Errors, because of these errors are made by the system based languages. But coming to compile time errors are defined in simple English language, that is for user friendly language. Whatever the user can be used in that language, the errors are also defined by that language. So hence, every user can understand the compile time error. So compile time errors like such as missing semicolon, missing commas, missing double quotes, missing semicolon, missing dots, or whatever it may be. We are easily understand the compile time errors. Okay, compile time errors when it is occurred. Compile time error is one of the error. Compile time error is one of the error which is occurred. That means it is being placed here when it does not follow the syntax rules. When it does not follow the syntax rules, that means when we missing the syntax rules, we are also facing some problems here. The problems is also known as the syntax rules. Okay, that is called as the compile time errors. Compile time errors can be defined in simple English language. So the user can be easily understand this type of errors. Okay, but coming to runtime errors occurred while we are entering invalid inputs. Okay, so runtime errors is also it is happened when we executing the program. Executing means giving a runtime errors is called as runtime errors. Okay, so runtime errors are not managed by the user, because of the runtime errors can be given by the system based on the system based language. System based language is not accepted by the user because of the user friendly language is called as English or Spanish, whatever it may be. But coming to user friendly language is called runtime errors. Those are called as array index out of bound exception, string index out of bound exception, class not found exception, no class found exception, arithmetic exception, so IO exception. These are called as exceptions. So exception means runtime errors are also called as exception. Okay, these exceptions are not understood by the user. Okay, using exception handling topic, we can easily convert it to system based language into user friendly language with the help of the exception handling topics. In the exception handling topics, there is a some types of the available here. So those are called as a try, catch, block. This statement can be accessed here. Okay, so this is called as the exception handling. Okay, so runtime errors can be made by the system based language. So also user cannot understand the system based language. So by using exception handling, we can convert the system based language into our user friendly language. The user can do whatever the user can understand the language. Maybe an English language. Okay, it can be available in English language. So that's why the user can easily understand the given by the these types. Okay. So this is errors of coming from based on the runtime errors. Okay. So runtime errors means what we, that means the runtime means execution time. We are giving input values. This called as runtime values. Okay. So here I'm giving the variable having the same values here and the start with dollar sign, and the variable is always declared with the symbol of using a dollar symbol. By using dollar symbol, you can declare the variable in PHP programming styles. And example can be declared here. So in yesterday, I was discuss about the basics of the PHP code using the some syntax. And the PHP code is written within the HTML tag. HTML tag is a plain text area. And here I am going to discuss about the this type of thing here. And the, if you want to write your PHP code, you have to use the extension .php extension is necessary to write the, to save the program with the PHP styles. Okay, PHP programming is also not right. There is headers. So there is a Notepad plus plus is also support with the PHP programming styles. Okay, here and going to here, and the PHP is always starts with the angular braces, open angular braces, question mark PHP, and the closer is and the closest is question mark with closed angular braces. That is what is the, this is the PHP starting, and this is the PHP closing. In this between these two statements, we have to write our code here. Okay, we have to write code here. So here I am declaring some variables. A variable named as a, I have used three variables. I am using here. I am using three variables. Okay. So what is variable here? We simply find the variables in PHP programming styles because of the every variable can its have before the variable name. We have to place our dollar symbol. The dollar symbol, where there is dollar symbol, that the side values is treated as a variable. Okay, so here text text is the one of the variable of its type dollar. So the dollar means what here? A dollar is a represent the variable name. Variable name. So that's my text is the text file. Okay, text is always engaged with the hello world. Hello world. Okay, since this statement can be ended with a semicolon. The statement can be ended with any semicolon. In every programming language, every statement can be ends with a semicolon. Okay, ends with a semicolon. So I am using this type of scenarios. Okay, so here I am using another variable named as x. Okay, what is the value here? Named as x. next is balanced to 7. Next is equal to 7. X value is 7 value. Value of x is equal to 7. And the dollar y is equal to 7.5. Dollar y is equal to 7.5. So here I am taking three different values based on the variables. Okay. So here I am taking first variable. Is it treated as a, what is here? Is it treated as a string? String entity. What is string here? String is a collection of characters enclosed by double quotes. Okay. Collection of characters is called a string. And it can be enclosed with by double quotes. And it can be enclosed with by double quotes. And same type is balanced to the string data types. Okay. Next coming topic is called as strings. In the strings topics, I will discuss what is strings here. Okay. So let us see here. And the x is equal to 7. So here x as treated as a integer variable. Integer variable. And so there is no fractional code, there is no decimal parts are available here. Okay. Only numeric is also available here. Or let's say x is equal to 7. And this is the integer variable. I think it is belongs to the integer variable. Okay. Hence, I am using another variable. That is what y is equal to 7.5. So this is also one of the variable name as y, and it is the followed by the dollar symbol. Dollar symbol is used by the dollar symbol is used by representation of the variable. Okay, this is called as one of the example, and this program output can be like this. Now hello, and the value is 7.5. This is the answer by getting these problems. Okay, so I'm going to print this like the TSD variable and the x variable and y variable. Okay, so what is variable here? A variable can be defined is like this. A variable is identifier whose value is changed during the execution of the program. Okay. So while entering the values at the time of the runtime, at the time of the executing time, the program is always giving a different values to the user. That means the result will be coming based on the given by the user input values. The result is also different from the from one user to another user. Because of the all users cannot enter same values. Okay, that's why the user can be enter values his convenience and easiest values to enter this program. Okay, in some students giving same values, they are getting also same output. Okay, so maximum people are giving distinct values and also getting the distinct outputs based on the their input values, and the variable also giving the different values. Okay, this situation is known as the variables. Okay, so variable is a very distinct facility in programming languages. In PHP is also a variable is provided a distinct facility to writing a program in PHP styles. Okay, so a PHP style is the program is in PHP programming is also one of the PHP program is also containing some variables. That variable is defined by the following symbol, that is called as a dollar symbol. Okay, so if you are declaring any variable, that variable before you have to enter some symbol. That symbol is named as a dollar symbol. The symbol is named as dollar symbol. Okay, so without dollar symbol, if you are entering any variable, that variable that is not treated as a variable name. Okay, if you treat it as a variable name, you have to use your following symbol the symbol is known as the dollar symbol. Dollar symbol can be placed before the variable name. Dollar symbol can be placed before the variable name. Okay, the dollar symbol can be placed either you are taking an integer or string or character or whatever it may be, or taking boolean data types. What are the data types you have to take? You have to specify the dollar symbol before the data types of the before the variable name. Okay, you have to enter a dollar sign. Okay, that is called as the declaration of the variable. Okay, so here you want to declare the variable, you have to follow the some rules. Okay, rules for declaring the names are not accepted by the user convenience, but the user can follow the some syntax rules. Some rules are followed by when you are declaring. When you are declaring the variable names, you have to follow some rules. Okay, so without following the any rules of the PHP program, it does not accept the variable names. Okay, if you declare the variable names, you have to follow the sub rules. Okay, the first part is always known as the variable name is always what the variable name is always character or alphabet. This is called ADC, and you have to use it or capital ABC. Accepts only alphabets. So name will given. Named as a given name as a variable name as a intercept, that is called A, B, C, D up to Z. Okay, the letters are going to retain in the form of the uppercase or lowercase, whatever it may be. Okay, the first letter must be the alphabets. Okay, next, it not accepts any numbers. Zero line, first letter that be accepts any dollar symbol, any hash symbol, and any question mark symbol, and any exclamation symbol. Okay. Variable name, first name, the variable name is not starts with the any special symbols such as numbers. Numbers is also not accepted here, and the special symbols also not accepted here. Okay. It accepts only underscore symbol. Okay. So next, it does not start with the first letter. Must be, you have to use the first letter must be compulsory. Treated as a 100% as a first letter must be alphabet. Okay. After that, using the alphabet, you have to use any numbers or any symbols as you wish. Okay. Next, coming to here, it accepts only one symbol, that is named as a your variable name. The variable name is always starts with underscore symbol. The variable name is always starts with underscore symbol. That's why I'm using this type of scenarios. That's why I'm using this type of the scenarios to use to build the programs in the PHP styles. Okay. Next, PHP rules. Okay. Next, PHP variable should not follow in the PHP syntaxes of the rules. It is called in PHP. We are using some keywords like echo or PHP and whatever it may be. The variable name should not be keywords. Should not be keywords. Variable names should not be the keywords. we are using without keywords, we are using any name of the variable as you wish. Okay, coming to keywords, you are not treated as a its variable names. Okay, you have to use their keywords. You have to use without keyword names as a variable name. That is the a good example for this scenarios. Okay, so this is what is it. Variable in PHP styles. So tomorrow I will give you a lecture on the PHP styles. Okay, PHP variable data types. Okay, what are the data types available in PHP? Let us come to here and explain about this type of thing PHP here. Okay, so this map belongs to the third BSc computer science paper. Okay, so this is the cluster paper. I hope that everyone can understand this type of the lessons. I will give you notes in the PDF format of the offline sections only. So coming to here, I will discuss you one more time. What is PHP variables here? Okay, so PHP means what here? PHP means what here? PHP is a lightweight programming language. Okay, it can be run across the server side applications. PHP can run within the plain text area, that is called as a HTML. Okay, if you want to learn the PHP, you have to know the minimum knowledge is called as a HTML and the CSS and JS. JS means what here? JS is the JavaScript. JavaScript is also needed here to establish this PHP coding styles. Okay, so in previous class I will discuss about the structure of PHP. I was discussing in previous class, and today I am giving one of the example for this to write the PHP variables. Okay, so today topic is PHP variable. What is PHP variable? So what is variable here? A variable is a container. What is it? A variable is a container. It can store the values. It can be stored the values based on the given data types. Based on the given data types. So that's why the variable can take based on the data types, it can take some valuable data. Okay, without the help of the data type, there is no chance of depending the variable. Okay, variable not depend the simple as it alone. Okay, next, so if you have to use the variable, you have to declare and use the next for the coming topics. Okay, directly not use the variable. Okay, if you want to use the variable, first of all you have to declare the variable as its relevant data type. Okay, so don't use the don't declare the data types after the using of the variable. If you are doing that, you have to face some problems. That is called syntax errors. That means untypement symbol something. So hence this process to overcome this, we have to declare the variable as a its as its named as a its data type. So that's why I am using this type of scenarios. Okay, so this is called as a variable. Next, whenever we declare the variable, we have to use, before the variable name, we have to use some special symbol. The special symbol is named as a dollar symbol. If you are using, if you are defining the variable name, the variable name before, you have to enter dollar symbol. That means, the dollar symbol can indicate the variable name. Dollar symbol can indicate the variable name. So that's why I am using this variables. Okay. So in this program, I am totally taking three variables. First variable is text variable, text. Okay. So this is called dollar. Hence it is called as text. So for example, I am not declaring any dollar symbol. So it is x is equal to 7, but here x is not belongs to the variable. because the variable is followed by symbol is called as a dollar. That's why I am using the symbol before the variable name. Okay, dollar x, dollar y, dollar txt. These are the variable names. Okay, and giving the values are based on txt is belongs to string type, x is equal to belongs to integer type, y is belongs to float type. That's why we are declaring the variables as a different manner. Okay, this is the class of the PHP variables. I will discuss you in the next class what are the PHP dynamics. Okay, I think everyone can understand this topics. Please watch this class. After this class, if you have any doubts, please ask me. Okay, thank you. Thanks for watching this.